Tonight, on our continuing coverage of Arizona technology and innovation, we take a look at a new research facility recently opened at Arizona State University. It's a state-of-the-art structure designed to spur innovation and showcase research. Here to talk about the new building is Seth Raman Pantanathan. He's Senior Vice President of ASU's Office of Knowledge Enterprise Development, and I think I got that name right.
You got it right. It's amazing.
That's amazing.
That's
we should
awesome,
build it.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
Okay, this is an amazing structure. Talk to us about what was behind this, how long it's been taken from the idea to getting the doors open here.
Yes. So this is one of the interdisciplinary science and technology buildings. We call them the ISTB buildings. So we've had a number of those buildings. We had ISTB 1, 2, 3. This is the fourth one. And we already have 5 because it was one of the existing buildings that got converted. We have the Biodesign Institute buildings also. So this was actually thought about 4 years ago. And then we designed it. We knew that this was going to be a place, a home for our School of Earth and Space Exploration. We're going to put some research groups into that, and I will talk about that very soon.
Sure.
And so we knew what we were going to build and how what kind of space that we would want. And this is the single largest research building so far at ASU.
And it's got, we're looking right now, it looks like moon-driven, Mars-driven kind of stuff on display. It's interesting because you got a lot of high-tech labs in there. Some of those on the first and second floors, they're open to the public. People can watch scientists at work, correct?
That's correct. So we want to make sure that whatever is happening inside the building is also available for the public to get to see and get inspired by. Let's take, for example, our K-12 students today. We are looking for a lot of those students interested in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math disciplines, and establish careers around those. So this building and visiting this building and engaging with the researchers, looking at some of the things that's going on inside the building, is bound to inspire those youth to get interested in wanting to pursue STEM careers.
And the meteorite collection will go a long way as well.
Huh? Absolutely. It is exciting to be able to touch, feel, and look at those meteorite samples. And we've got a meteorite vault, which is very unique, one of a kind in the country.
As far as the work being done, R&D on security and defense, that's being done. R&D on renewable energy, that's being accomplished there as well.
That's correct. So we have a security and defense systems initiative that we launched recently. And we hired a very senior scientist from the U.S. Air Force, the chief scientist there in Pentagon, Werner Dahm. He's coming and leading that initiative right now at ASU. Now, this initiative, as you can imagine, the Metro Phoenix area and Arizona at large is a hotbed for all the companies in the aerospace and defense area. So we have a good positioning in terms of working with those companies and essentially helping with the economic development of our state and also working on national security issues that benefits our nation.
This is ASU's most expensive, $185 million, huh?
That's correct. In fact, we have had this building constructed under budget and in a shorter time than we originally envisioned. So it is one of those nice projects to have launched.
And it sounds as though, and we've talked about this on the program before, the idea, of course, is to get research going, but not only to get research going, but to develop things, get patents for those things, wind up getting the patents turning into startup businesses. You got jobs, you got everything circling back in, you got a self-perpetuating system there, don't you?
That's exactly it. So the other form of economic impact, in addition to working with industry, so you pick the renewable energy area, for example.
Yes.
We have an advanced battery center located in this building, and that faculty member is already commercializing the technology that is coming out here. He has got a Department of Energy funding that has incubated the ideas. The ideas are now getting into the marketplace. So this is causing economic impact. Jobs will be created. And just in the last year alone, for example, from the research enterprise, we have over 180 intellectual property disclosures across ASU. And this is increasing year after year after year. And these result in patents. Those patents get licensed by companies or become the basis for new companies to be created.
How does this, and I think I know the answer, but I think it might be a little confusing as well. SkySong seems to be somewhat similar, correct? I mean, what's the difference between these two?
So here in this building, the research happens. That research outcome is now taken to a place like SkySong, where a faculty member or a student would take that idea and then build their company around. And SkySong provides the environment, the training modules for them to think about how to start a company, as well as providing the incubation space to allow their company to get started and then attract venture investment or angel investment.
Before this building was constructed, these scientists were working in different buildings, different labs, these sorts of things.
That's correct.
How much of a difference does this make?
This makes a huge difference in the following sense. First of all, this is a state-of-the-art facility. Secondly, it brings researchers from multiple disciplines, and that's what interdisciplinary is all about, brings researchers from multiple disciplines and co-locates them. So the bouncing of ideas and generation of new ideas and being together creates an ecosystem that makes it a very, very creative place, where they are in the individual locations, they tend to work in their small problems, but now they can work on these larger problems for the solutions for which require all these expertise being brought together.
And you can also work on some of these things while you know that other folks are watching your work, and which is, I think it's absolutely fascinating. David, this Mars rover, we saw that in the video clip, there's a replica of the Curiosity right there in the door.
Exactly. So we have the 2,000-pound Curiosity rover, which is right now on Mars, and we have got a reduced version of it, a smaller version of it, right in the building. As you enter the foyer, on the left-hand side, you will see this Mars Curiosity rover right there, because it was something that we participated in with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in NASA, and our scientists work on NASA programs, including the next program, which is going to be mining the asteroids. So some of the work for the instrumentation is going to happen in the building. So as you enter the building, these are glass enclosures, so you can actually see what's going on. And we wanted people to experience that, so that it is not behind closed doors, but it is something that people can watch and get inspired by.
I know there was one, the looking at the camera images from the asteroid research was in there as well. And you can basically watch scientists getting those images, correct?
That's correct. So the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter program is exactly that. The real-time images that come from that program, people can watch and in fact, they can even control the cameras and take pictures as they would like to see the different parts of the surface of the moon.
Is there room for, you get a brand new building, you get a brand new home, you think you're never going to move. What's next with you guys out there?
So we are always planning for the next thing, because just to put it out there, our research expenditures, which is an indicator of how robust we are in terms of research growth, has tripled in the last 10 years. So we are now in the top 20 universities, in the league of top 20 universities in the nation, without a medical school, in terms of our research performance. In the league of universities like MIT, Caltech, and University of Texas, Austin, and things of that, universities of that caliber. So we are advancing very rapidly, and therefore, as you advance, and we have a doubling goal from here by 2020, which means that we need more newer facilities, and we're going to make sure that we're planning for them now in order that we will get them ready and online.
Well, sounds like things are happening. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity, Ted.
You bet.
Being with you. Thanks.